When you head to the doctor, you probably assume that whatever medication they give you is the best thing for that illness. But that's not always the case, and I've got attorney Seth Katz with me now to talk about the dangers of a new blockbuster drug. So Seth, another story about a drug company killing consumers. Again, you're at the lead of this, you're heading this up, and you've seen this before. You were one of the people that led the charge in Yaz. Did a great job there, actually uncovering some really ugly conduct by the drug company, Bayer. Tell us about this story. Where's it going?
Thanks, Mike. This story is a drug that really was not needed in this country. It's a drug that was one of convenience. You know, they marketed it as people who couldn't get well controlled, or anybody who was on warfarin. You don't have to go to your doctor. You don't have to go do this. You can eat anything you want. Take Pradaxa. What they didn't tell you is that this blood thinner won't stop. That they can't control a bleed. That there's
in other words, what Seth, the problem is we had a drug on the market that worked just fine.
Absolutely.
And then along comes this company. What is the name of this company?
Boehringer Ingelheim.
Okay, so Boehringer Ingelheim comes up and they says we want to sell a drug. It's not that the market needs the drug. The other drugs that's on the market is working just fine, but they see the chance for a cash cow. The same thing that you uncovered with Yaz. Now, tell us how dangerous this cash cow is.
This cash cow is very dangerous, because, Mike, if you start bleeding, there's no reversal agent. If you're taking warfarin or Coumadin and you start to bleed, you cut yourself in the kitchen, you cut yourself shaving, and you can't stop the bleeding, you can take vitamin K and they can stop the bleeding. If you're taking Pradaxa and you start to bleed, there's no known reversal agent. So what are the doctors to do? Well, they can try to put you on dialysis, but that involves potentially more puncture wounds.
Did
so
they
it's a
know
very
about
dangerous...
this, Seth? Did this company know from a clinical standpoint what the dangers were when they put this product on the market, that it could be something as simple as showing up in an emergency room, you've taken Pradaxa, fairly minor injuries, but you're bleeding and the doctor's thinking, how do I stop the bleeding? Did the company know that was a problem when they put the product on the market?
Absolutely. They knew that there was no known reversal agent. They knew that if someone presented to the emergency room, the doctors wouldn't know, because they didn't put it in the label adequately, that there was no known way to stop the bleeding.
Let me ask you, in the Yaz case, you were able to uncover fraud where we found out that the clinicals that were actually performed and the clinicals that were reported to doctors were actually phonied up. They just were just fantasy clinicals. Are you finding that early on in the Pradaxa case?
Not yet, but we expect to find more. What we are finding is what the company did with its study was they took people that were taking Coumadin in third world countries, in underdeveloped countries, and developing countries, and they took those people who don't get the medical care that we have in the U.S. and the developed parts of Europe, and what they did was they took the results of that part of the study and mixed it in with the results of people in the U.S. and in Italy and in the European countries where medical care is good. And when you take something at the real low end of the spectrum, it's going to bring down the results to make the people at the higher end of the spectrum look like this drug's not working for them when it is. And
well, let me ask you this. The detailers, the people who went to doctors and sold this product to doctors, they were telling doctors, use this drug and you won't have to monitor the patient. The patient won't have to go back for blood tests to see if the product is damaging their kidney, to see if the levels are too high. So they sold this to doctors. The doctor thought, well, that's great. That's easy. Let me use this product, because the competitor did warn you need to monitor if you're taking this blood thinner. Did I get that right?
You did, Mike. You got that absolutely correct. And that was the angle that they tried to develop this market in. You know, they developed it for the doctors and for the patients. Hey, you don't want to go to your doctor every 3 to 4 weeks to make sure that your blood ratios are in the proper zone and making sure that warfarin is working. Just take Pradaxa. You don't need to go get monitored every 3 or 4 weeks. But what they didn't tell people was the risk, that there's no known way to stop the bleeding. And they also didn't tell people that the product can cause GI bleeding.
In about a minute, tell me, if you would, Seth, how many people are taking this drug and what advice would you give them right now?
This is a blockbuster product. There are millions of people taking this product and they're all at risk. And they don't know it because the company still isn't adequately warning that there is no known reversal agent. These people need to get to their doctors, need to talk to their doctors about whether or not this is the right product, and I submit it's not. That they can be well controlled, they can get the same result, safer results by going back and using warfarin or Coumadin.
And just to close this, within a year of the release of this product, there were thousands of injuries that were reported both to the FDA and to this company, wasn't it?
Thousands.
So to wrap it up with this idea, is this another question of the FDA dropping the ball?
It is a question of the FDA dropping the ball and a company putting a product out there so they could make money regardless of human safety, regardless of medical condition, just praying to the almighty dollar.
Seth Katz, thank you for joining us. Keep us up on stories like this on Ring of Fire, where the corporate media will never report these stories. Thank you for joining me.